हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक क्लास 11। टुडे आई एम डिस्कसिंग लूपिंग कंसेप्ट। ओके, सिंपल टू हार्ड वी कैन से नेस्टिंग लूप कंसेप्ट। सो हियर आई एम टेकिंग ए वेरी सिंपल एग्जांपल, ओके, टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस। First thing is you can see simple way without looping. Okay, you can see this is our 1, this is our 1 and 2, this is our 1, 2, 3. You can see my mouse pointer, you can see. So 1, then 1, 2, then 1, 2, 3. Okay, in this style I want to print our data. Okay, without loop. First we can understand without loop. Okay, we can say also this is a pyramid. We can say this is a pyramid of 1 1 2 1 2 3. We can say left aligned pyramid. So simply we can use print statement, print in bracket, we can use double quotes. We know very well print, always print data in a new line. Okay, print 1 2, and then we can use print 1 2 3. What is the output? You can see 1, then 1 2, then 1 2 3. This is our output, you can see. This is the simple way, but I want to display this data with the help of while loop. Okay, we can say loop below loop, loop after loop, using while loop. Same program I want to convert into while loop. Okay, so in while loop we can use I is equal to 1. Okay, because first I want to display 1, so I is equal to 1. Okay, because only 1 first, so 1 while less than equal to 1, print I plus 1. Okay, so it will display 1 and I plus 1 2, then 2 less than 1 it will false and print, and then print statement will work, and this is the empty print statement, so it will move the cursor in the next line. This print statement move the cursor in next line. Okay, the next time I want 1 and 2, so here I am starting loop 1 and here I am using while loop I less than equal to 2, then I am using print I, it will display 1, then end is equal to in single quotes, because I want to display in continuation in same line, so here I am using additional thing, end is equal to in single quotes, then I plus 1 means 1 plus 1 2, again loop will continue, 2 less than equal to 2, yes, equal to 2, again it will display 2, you can see it will display 2, and end it will display in same line. Okay, then I plus 1 means 2, 2 plus 1 3, so 3 less than equal to 2, it will false, it jump to the print statement, so our cursor will move in next new line in advance, our cursor will move in new line in advance in this statement. Now next time I want 1 2 3, so here I am using loop 1 less than equal to 3, print I and end is equal to single quotes and I plus 1, so this loop will display in same line 1 2 3, and loop will false when I will reach to the 4. So you can see the complete output of this program. First this statement display 1, then print will display cursor in new line, then I want to display 1 and 2 but in same line, so here I am using end is equal to, so here 1 2 in continuation, then print statement will move the cursor in next line, then I want to 3, so I and less than equal to 3, it will display 1 2 3. Okay, next time there is no need to put, so the complete output you can see 1 1 2 1 2 3. But same program I want to convert into for loop, because in while loop you can see there are number of instructions, this is very lengthy program, so I want to convert into compact form, I want to in compressed form, so same program I want to convert in for loop. So first I want to display 1, then 1, 2, then 1, 2, 3. So here I am using I in range 1, 2. Okay. So it will display only from 1 to 1. Okay. It will display only 1. Then cursor will move into next line. Okay. Now same program, but here I in range 1, 3 means 1 to 2 it will execute. So it will display 1. Then end is equal to, it will display 2 in same line. Then loop will continue 2 and 3 will not work. Then cursor, it will false and jump to the print statement. So cursor will move into the new line. Okay, in advance. Now I want to display 1, 2, 3. So here I am starting I in range 1, 4. So 1, 2, 3. So 1, then 2 will attach and 3 will attach in same line, because here I am using end is equal to, and 4 will reach, that it will false. So the output of this code, you can see 1, then 1, 2, then 1, 2, 3. You can see this is our output. So this loop, below loop, this is not a nesting. This while loop, this is not a nesting, because loop below loop, not loop inside loop. This is also loop below loop, not loop inside loop. So here our code also is very lengthy. Okay. Now same program I want to convert into loop inside loop. Here I am talking a new thing, loop inside loop with the help of while and for loop. So same program I want to convert this while convert into nesting while. So you can see here I am using here, because in inside box you can see this is our inner loop, because this is the inside, and this is outer box, you can see this is our outer loop, this is our outer loop. So here outer loop, okay, you can see here outer loop controls all the rows. So outer box, you can see this loop control all the rows. So how many rows? You can see first, second and third, total we have three rows. So here I want to change. Okay, so total we have three rows. So here I am using 3. Okay, because total we have 3 rows. Okay, so R means row. Here loop will start R is equal to 1 while 1 is less than equal to 3. Yes, it is true. Now the inside loop control all the columns of a particular row, because this is our first row have only one column, this is our second row. Okay, this is our second row have two columns, this is our third row have three columns. So inside loop control all the columns of a particular row, you can see R is equal to 1, because total we have three rows. R less than equal to 3, okay, 1 is, it is true, so it will move inside. C is equal to 1, okay, 1, C, 1 less than equal to R, what is the value of R is 1, so it will execute one time. So it will display print C, you can see 1, and end there is nothing, and C plus 1, so 2, so 2 less than 1 it will false, and it jump to the outside the loop. R is equal to R plus 1, what is the last value of R? 1, 1 plus 1, 2, now R is 2. So it will jump to the directly in while loop. So 2 less than equal to 3, yes, it is again true. So it move inside, again C is equal to 1. So 1 less than equal to 2. So it will display C means 1, and here continuation, and 1 plus 1, 2. So 2 less than equal to 2, again true, it will display 2. So you can see 1 and 2. Then end continuation, then 2 plus 1, 3. So 3 is false, and again control move to the outside this inner loop. R plus 1, what is the last value of R? 2. 2 plus 1, 3, and put the cursor in new line in advance. Okay, put in advance. then it will again come to the outer loop, because outer loop is running. So 3 less than, okay, equal to 3 again. So again, see, we said 1, okay, so 1 less than equal to 3, so it will display 1, 2, 3. C will reach to the 4, it will false, and R plus 4, R plus 1, 3, R 3 plus 1, 4, R is equal to 3 plus 1, 4, print new line, but here 4 less than equal to 3, the outer loop also false, so it will not move inside, so it will stop the program. So with the help of nesting, we can minimize our coding. So outer loop control all rows and inner loop control all columns of a particular row. So same program I want to convert into for loop. So it will reduce our number of statement, only 4 lines, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, in while loop, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 line. But in for loop, we can only use 4 lines and we will get the same output. This is our very minimum amount of coding. So you can see, okay, here outer loop control the total rows. Total rows 1, 2, 3. So here I am beside, I in range 1, 4. Or in inside, for each row, it controls the total number of column. So C in range 1. Always, because 1 is common, 1, 1, 2, then 1, 2, 3. So R plus 1, what is the value of R? 1. 1 plus 1, 2. So it will run, it will display 1. Okay, print. So it will move the cursor in new line, then again move. What is the next value of R? 2. C in range 1, 2 plus 1, 3. So 1 to 2 it will display. So 1 and 2 you can see. Then again print, it will move the next line. Then again loop, the last value of R is 3. So C in range 1, 3 plus 1, 4. So 1, 2, 3. So it will display 1, 2, 3. And print new line. Then next, 4 is not available because range always 1 less. So it will fall. So it will display 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. So outer loop control outer all rows and inner loop control all the columns in each row. So you can see, this is without loop concept and this is our while loop concept, but output is same. So we can use any concept, we can use for loop, we can use loop inside loop. In while concept we can make this program, and we can also use for loop, outer loop and inner loop to produce the same result. Okay, I think hope you understand this example comparatively. Okay, students, thank you so much.